Now, tomorrow marks 50 years since Young Talent Time first hit Aussie screens.
Yep, the must-see family TV show aired right here on Channel 10 from 1971 to 1988 and again in 2012, catapulting the long-running careers of Danny Minogue and Tina Arena.
And the iconic music show is set to make a comeback to celebrate its 50th anniversary. Two of the show's most famous faces, Johnny Young and Bevan Adansall, join us now to tell us more. Hello, fellas.
Hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
Awesome.
And did you notice that the early episodes were all in black and white still?
Yeah, I know.
Incredible.
That was a great little trip down memory lane.
Oh, wasn't it wonderful? For me too, you know, because... It wasn't just for 5 minutes, it was for 18 years. Yeah. And for 18 years, we were on every week. Because we did 42 new episodes, and then we did a summer series, which was sort of made up, and but we hosted it and did all of that stuff. It was fantastic. And look at Tina. Goodness. I mean, she's touring at the moment. She's one of the biggest stars in the world. But she was a star already when she was 8 or 9 years old. You know, you could see she had... look at this.
It's incredible. Yeah. The Young Talent Time cast will be reuniting on May 1. So will we... wonderful Bevan is performing for us this morning and is involved. Yeah. Who else is involved in this reunion special?
Well, Bevan is the chief, you know. He's the apprentice, Johnny Young.
Yeah, that's right. You're handing the baton now.
I'm handing over the baton. And he's doing a wonderful job too, by the way.
Look, so tomorrow at 7 p.m. marks the exact second that Young Talent Time started in 1971. So we're going to have over 20 of us in the one spot. We're going to do a Facebook Live, just say, look, we're all here to record the special. We're doing it over the weekend and it'll be shown, as I said, it'll become live on May 1 on youngtalenttime.tv.
Brilliant.
And some live performances by the team now, including Jane Scully, Philip Gould, Karen Knowles, Stephen Zammit, Greg Porton, myself.
Do I have to sing All My Loving at the end?
No Young Talent Time can ever happen without All My Loving at the end. That is the number one rule.
That was the sign you had to go to bed.
Yeah, that's right. And you know, we scoured the world to try to find the right host for this special, and we had to get it right. So I'm really proud to announce that the host is going to be Mr. Johnny Young. It's going to be amazing. it couldn't be anyone else, could it?
But like I said, it's such an epic platform for people. We're going to play a little game of where are they now. Bevan, maybe you can tell us about some of the cast who've made it big overseas since leaving.
Well, look, you were talking about Danny and Tina. Of course, they are two of the biggest names to ever come out of the show. And, you know, Danny's... she keeps so busy. Of course, there she is with Kylie. And, of course, I was just the other day looking at some vision of my surprise. Prize 15th birthday, where Danny's there dancing and so's Kylie, and no one knew Kylie yet. But Danny had already been on TV for quite a few years.
Yeah. So that was before her Neighbours days.
Absolutely, yeah. Well, she started in Henderson Kids before Neighbours. And so seeing all that old footage and you think, well, what has become since then? And, of course, Tina, what a pro. She really is one of the great performers in the world.
How did it change and shape your life? Because you were just a baby. You were 12 when
you started. I came from a little country town called Dimboola, which is halfway between Melbourne and Adelaide.
Footballers come from Dimboola.
Tim Watson, Merv Nagle. We're absolutely both mad Essendon supporters, you see. So, I was down in a cross-country run because my whole life was about sport and music. And I was at a friend's house and I was playing. They had a piano and I'm only 12, couldn't play it very well, and I'm singing along. And they said, you know, we've seen in the paper that John Young is looking for a new boy for the show. You should audition. And my parents were on the way back to Dimboola, stopped at a phone box, called Television House, my dad said, you know, I think my son's got a pretty good voice. Can he get an audition?
You're kidding.
And the producers said, well, we've already seen 5,000 boys, but if you come in right now, we'll see him. So you clearly hadn't found exactly what you wanted at the time. My dad came around. I did an audition. They said, come back the next day. I played the piano and they said, we'll get Greg Mills to do it. It was very good. And came back in and auditioned, and then 2 days later, I think you even called my mum and said, he's got the gig.
Yeah.
And mum said, when does he start? He's already started. Get down here. So mum and dad sold the house in the country straight to Melbourne, and that's where it all started.
And it was intense being on the show, right? Because you were not only juggling the show, you were filming a
huge production every week outside of school time. But that's where we had the support of...
But we have to tell the truth. He had a little bit of ADHD.
ADHD. 100%.
So he was fine while he was dancing, but in between he'd be climbing up walls and doing all sorts of
things. Oh, you sound like my son.
I don't know about the walls. not sure about the walls. But
but the thing about Bevan was his personality once, but his singing voice, I mean, wonderful. You're going to sing today.
Oh, we're getting a full performance. We're so excited.
If you'll have me, I might warble out a little tune, if that's okay.
Yeah, look at it.
Oh, that was my dog, Ben. And now I have a son, Ben. That's a bit weird, isn't it? It's only just hit me that I named my... Name my son after the dog. Okay.
You were today years old when you worked that out. You also used to wear like quite the stylish mullet, and you had some leather ties and lemon pants.
Yes, I have them. They're in a museum. No, they're not. I was having a look at the photo that's up that's going to be behind me when I'm singing, and I looked and I thought, you know what? Particularly with COVID, I've put on 200 kilos since that photo, but I've lost it in hair, so I'm about the same. That mullet was ridiculous. It was.
Johnny, you were sort of like you were the kind of the father figure to all these kids.
No, because I was only 24 when Young Talent Time started. See, it's 50 years ago.
But when you're five, that seems very old.
But I was like, because I formed the idea for Young Talent Time on the Mickey Mouse Club, and they had Jimmy, who was like the older brother, and that's the role I wanted to play. You know, the older brother. We used to sit on the host set. And I never felt that far removed from the kids.
In between shots, we'd be having a ball. We'd be having a heap of fun.
And it was also because I was just married and was just having kids and I was still doing some radio and stuff like that. I just fell into it. It was like, you know, rejoining the family.
Yeah, and that's what the feeling we're about to get too, isn't it? I mean, we're so excited to have everyone come back together. Of course, we haven't got everyone that was ever in the show, but we did ask everybody. It's just the people, obviously, and particularly with what's happened in the last year and the pandemic, it's just been hard for people to get around. And other people do different things with their lives now. They've said, you know, we loved our time. Congratulations, it's going to be wonderful. It's not for me now because they've got a very different direction. But some of the biggest stars in Australia are going to be there. I mean, Philip Gould, he sang for the Queen. Jane Scully won 7 MOA awards. I mean, the lineup when you look at it, it's really impressive what a grounding that Young Talent Time was for these guys to go on and yeah. and be huge stars. I mean, I've been floating around the ocean in the last 3 weeks as a cruise director, but that stopped pretty rapidly.
But it's also a huge part of nostalgia for people that makes up such a big part of their lives, you know?
Yeah,
so it's going to be a great family show to get people back together. Johnny, we're also here that you're working on something else that's quite profound.
Well, quite profound. About 3 years ago, my very best friend started to behave in a way that I was unaccustomed to with him. He was a wonderful businessman, very successful, excellent sports person, and a great singer as well. So, I thought at first that he may have alcoholism or yeah. something like that, because his behaviour was, you know, unusual. Anyway, his darling wife had him checked out, and he had dementia.
Aww.
So, you know, I knew nothing about dementia, because there's very little day-to-day literature on dementia. And even though it is there are more women die of dementia than any other disease. Mm. It's the second most, you know, profound. Mm. I decided, I rang a friend of mine who'd had a little experience in caring for carers. Mm-hmm. That's mm-hmm. what he did. That's Lee Tate. Hello, Lee. He's a great mate of mine. And so he introduced me to Alzheimer's WA, and I started to learn about dementia. Yeah. So the last 3 years I've spent learning and recording the experiences and the changes that have happened. And you know, my dear friend is going down the road, which will all be covered in a book, I guess. Mm. That's what I've been doing for the last 3 years, doing the Australian thing, which is perfect for this time of the year, isn't it? Mm. Mateship.
Yeah.
And that's all it is. I'm no expert, but I've learnt a lot, and I've tried to record it in a book.
Something that strikes me, John, that you were saying to me is that when... it's amazing how the brain works, where there's certain things you forget, an everyday task you forget how to do, yet... You can sing a song that you've remembered for
absolutely. You know, I mean, he
50 years.
He has no short-term memory, and you know, can't tie his shoelaces on occasions. But he remembers every song he's ever sung.
Wow. Music's amazing for that.
And it's an amazing component, a part of the story of dementia, is the memory of music. It plays such a significant part, right to your last breath. Yeah. You know, the music never leaves you, which is wonderful for me, because I'm a music person.
And it's beautiful as well that you're doing this kind of work when you spent so much of your life making beautiful memories for so many Australians. The song at the end, "Oh My Loving," that why that song? Was there a story behind
the Mickey Mouse Club, because the Mickey Mouse Club used to end, "Now it's time to say goodbye to all our family, M-I-C, see you real soon."
That's right.
You know, and everybody loved that feeling. You would almost miss the show just to catch that last bit where the family came together and whatever. So that was the feeling I wanted. I had recorded All My Loving as a single, you know, so I was familiar with the song. Being a songwriter, I wish I had have written it myself.
Yeah.
Paul McCartney's made a lot of money out of me over the years, but, you know, it was very early on in Young Talent Time that we did All My Loving. When I walk down the street, people sometimes don't recognise me, but they always go, "Close your eyes."
As I said, I always wanted to be on Young Talent Time, but I'm no longer young and don't have a lot of talent. I just want to have a. Can we do a little sing along with "All My Loving"? Can we put you on the spot?
Of course you can.
Yeah.
Do you know?
I know the song. Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Do you know that? Okay.
Yeah. So, we know Bevan is actually performing properly, but
this
is like a bucket list thing.
Close your eyes and I'll kiss you. Tomorrow I'll miss you. Remember, I'll always be true.
And then while I'm away, I'll run home every day.
And then while I'm away, I'll ride home every day.
Good night, John.
And I'll send all my loving to you.
Oh! Good night, Australia.
Do not miss Young Talent Time's 50th anniversary pay-per-view TV event on May 1st. You can snap up tickets for the event at youngtalenttime.tv. Johnny and Bevan, what a wonderful, wonderful segment. We've loved this. And
thank you for having us.